Now on RB Comics, another round of comedy, analytics, and adventure. The stupid reviews are on their way.
Welcome to RB Comics. If you're watching this, you've been chosen to write an audio drama. Congratulations.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Can I write the story now?
No.
Aww.
First, you need to get acquainted with the purpose, formatting, and practice of writing an audio play. Purpose. Back before movies were readily available and television invaded our homes, there was the radio drama. So why are we using it now when TVs are a dime a dozen and the cameras are everywhere? It's because animation takes more time and money than RB Comics has available. So we find different ways to tell the same story with the same amount of quality, but as quickly and cheaply as possible.
That does make sense! So, can I write the story now?
Haha, no! We're not even halfway through this video. Formatting. Like the precious, precious bones of an animal, formatting is the base upon which a script is built. It allows actors, directors, and sound designers to understand your vision and help make it a reality. We here at RB Comics don't adhere to an industry standard, but we do have a certain way in which things are written. It should look a little something like this. The scene section is pretty self-explanatory. Just the scene number, where you are, and it helps separate this scene from the last one. The SFX, or sound effects, section is a little trickier. Instead of writing, "She runs down a hallway," you picture the event in your mind and pick out each individual sound effect, listing them in an order that makes sense. If it's a particularly complicated event, you can add a little more description to carry it. Another example would read like this. It is a little harder to say you need rolling noises than it is to say he rolled into a wooden box, but you can still do a lot by just listing sound effects. The character and dialogue sections are also pretty self-explanatory, but there are still a few things you should keep in mind. 1. There is a character Bible. You have been linked to it. You should use it. 2. Listening to previous episodes or reading previous show scripts will help you nail the dialogue for your own script. 3. You don't have to write angry or sad in front of an actor's lines. Typically, the actor will know through context what he or she is supposed to be feeling, but you're not wrong if you do either.
Actually, Katie, you need to add in the emotions for most of the lines. How can anyone specifically know how angry or less sad they can be? We don't want to waste time doing re-recordings if that's not the emotional beat we are looking for in a scene. Especially if the actor just going to just skip ahead and just do only their lines.
Alright, fair point. You get just one, Mr. Moose.
Yeah!
Finally, a few color choices to further organize your script. The finished product should look like this.
Ooh, look at all the pretty colors! But character Bible? Tah, that's not too religiously for my blood. I'll just wing it.
Practice. Are you ready to learn the nuts and bolts of writing an audio play? Are you sure? All right, the secret to writing a good audio drama is... Sorry about that, folks. As I was saying, the secret formula to a good audio drama is... imagination.
What?
Imagination.
That's it? Heck, even I can use that stuff.
Sure, it's easy. Just close your eyes and listen for the sounds your mind creates to fill in the scene. Let's try some together, shall we?
Okay, disembodied voice.
Detective chases Pearl through the streets.
So there was the footsteps of the detective guy and the criminal running, and they tipped over a trash can, and then somebody stepped on the poor kitty, and then he ran ahead. I got it!
Great job, Mr. Moose. Let's try another. Try something spooky this time. Something more challenging this time. How about something NSFW?
Wow! Good night, everybody!